बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू आवर अनदर वीडियो। टुडे आई विल ट्राई टू कवर हाउ टू यूज़ कीबोर्ड प्रोफेशनली। यस, यू माइट आस्क व्हाट इज व्हाट यू मीन बाय प्रोफेशनली। वेल, यू हैव सीन मेजॉरिटी ऑफ पीपल, दे माइट बी टाइपिंग विद वन फिंगर और टू फिंगर। यस, दे कैन टाइप, but that looks not that much professional, and secondly their performance, they can type less as compared to people who are typing with all fingers, right? So they are using both hands and they can type very fast. Okay, now that need practice, but practice also needs certain standards to follow, or pattern, or keys. Otherwise, which finger will do what? You can't just do randomly. So there are certain rules or assigned keys to each finger, right? Okay. Normally, each keyboard will be just like this. Just I taken one Apple keyboard, because it is background was white, so I thought it will be nice to see. And all keyboards will have the same standard. Okay, now let's start. Now what you have to do, you have to remember this pattern and you have to follow. Initially you might need practice, maybe 1 to 2 weeks, then you will feel comfortable. Initially you might feel, what the hell is this, I am uncomfortable, this and that, you know, but yes, it needs time. Earlier days there were typewriters, so people were using even on typewriters the same way. So typewriters and keyboards are all same, keys locations are same. So if you know typewriter, you can use keyboard easily. But if you don't know both, so you have to follow what I am going to share with you today, right? Okay. Let's say, for example, if you have a keyboard in front of you, it is a laptop keyboard or wireless or Word, whatever. Okay, look at keys F and J. You will find something at the bottom, bit raised, you know, a line. So you, when you will touch, you will feel, yes, there is something, right? So if I will show you here, under F, this key is there. And under J, this is also there. That means even if your eyes are closed or you are not looking at your keyboard, still you can search where is F and J. So these keys are the standard for or center of your keyboard. So every time after typing, your hand should come on this. Means left hand forefinger should be on F, right hand forefinger should always be on J. So let's say, for example, once typing anything other than F, let's say R, it should come back again to F, V come back to V, right? Come back to F, right? So this is the first principle, and keyboard is showing that yes, even if you are not looking at your keyboard, you know my fingers are right placed or not. So your, let me take it left side, left hand, so it will be in front of you. Place your forefinger on F, middle finger on D, and ring finger on S, and small finger, lady finger you call it, A, right? So this hand will be on these four keys. Okay, forefinger will have another duty to go to G as well. So it will go to G and come back. It will not place on, or will be placed on G, but come back, right? Return to F. Same way, if we talk about on the right hand side, so this semicolon will be of small finger or lady finger. Then we have a ring finger, L, and K is for our middle finger. Four finger is J, and again four finger will go here, then return back. Right? Easy. So your middle line covered. Okay. Now let me remove these signs so you will not get confused. Now I will see four finger. So four finger will go to F to R, come back. It can go to V, come back. Okay. Same way, so this will be the pattern of your each finger, right? Now four finger, so in this case, if I take this one, it will have these six keys for four finger of left hand and six keys for right hand forehand four finger. Okay, now this will be for middle, this will be for ring, and this will be for small or ready finger, right? Space bar is used by thumb. Now it is up to you, you use left thumb or right thumb, but it is the thumb, right? Easy? Okay, what you have to do now, very first lesson, place your fingers on ASDF, right, the left, and semicolon, LKJ. What you can do, you can type your now lessons, and you have to say as well while typing, don't see at your keyboard, see on the screen. So first type ASDFGF. So what you have to do, come here, after this come back. So these three fingers will remain on ASD, but four finger will move to G and back on F, but always keep on F because there is a this sign is there, right? This small, this one here, right? Same way, from here you have to say semicolon LKJHJ. So if I take it up here, let me type something for you, notepad. So if I will take these, so you can write it down and then you have to follow. So I'm just okay, if you want to keep all capital letters, then you have to turn on caps lock. Caps lock on means it will always type in capital. If it is off, always it will type in the small. I will give the details of that shortly. So now I have turned on this caps lock. This is the my caps lock, this one. And now I am putting it ASDFGF. I am back on F, right? Space. I used thumb of right hand and then semicolon LKJHJ. Easy? So this is your first lesson. Practice this. Okay, once you will practice this, what you have to do now, you have to move up or down line, on up or down line. So if you have to move up, but after going up, you have to come back, right? Because your four fingers should be on F and J. Now, after maybe one day practice, or I don't know how much you will be comfortable, then I will say QWERT. QWERT. So from T you have to come back, but you will not come back on R, you will come back on F. Right? So it should be RT, and then let me type it over here. QWERTR and then F, then you have to come to F. So you will have that practice that you have to come back and then down. It will be easy from R. Once you will come here, let me give you example, here Then once you will come on R, then slide down. It will be easy, right? Same way, once you will be coming from POIUY, go to this and come down, right? It will be easy. Okay, then next day you will type ZXCVBV back, right? Forward slash dot comma MN again on M, go back, right? This is how you will use keyboard. Okay, then after this two lines practice, then you will practice from A Q A Z A. So your next lesson will be same way, A Q A Z A, then W S, this is X, sorry, no, wait, let me put it space, S X W S X S. Same way you have to do for all. So from here back. So key is your fingers should rest back after all typing, where four finger will be on J and F. You have to remember this, right? Okay, now let me remove these colors, and then let me show you what is the use of. Okay, tab normally is to have, if I'm not wrong, six spaces on the right side. So it will just jump six characters. Let me show it how it will be. So let's say, for example, I'm here, and if I put tab, so let me count. So you can't count, right? Yeah, see, it is just jumped. If you put another tab, it will again jump, right? So quick jumping. Okay, now if you see here on this side, you have this tab. Tab is done. Okay, now here there's a shift key. Shift key is on both sides. First function of this shift key is, let's say, for example, if caps lock is off, that means all these characters will be typed as small characters. But if you will press this shift key plus this characters, then it will become capital. So means, let's say, for example, if you have to type first capital letter, you will not switch on this caps lock, because this will reduce your speed, you know, on and off and this. So immediately you will press shift A, it will type A as a capital, right? But if caps lock is on, then shift A will become small A, right? So it is opposite. So normally in typing, we keep always caps lock off. We use shift to, if you have to somewhere use capital character. If you will keep shift pressed and you type on these letters, all will be capital until this shift key is pressed. Another function of shift key is, let's say, for example, if you need this at the rate, which is on the same key which has 2, so you will type shift 2, means it will type at the rate, or this sign, ampersand sign, hash key, ampersand sign, this is caret, percentage, dollar. So these shift you have to press, then these will work, or these parentheses, star, whatever, right? On the top there are function keys, right? If you see again on the top, there is a functionality of the keyboard, right? So those are normally with the function key plus this key, so it will have this I think brightness or whatever it is there, right? Speaker on, off, these are there. Okay, another very important key is this enter key or return key. Let me remove these lines by control Z, undo. this control key. Somewhere it you will see it enter ENTER, or sometimes you will find this as this arrow like this, or return, whatever. This is to jump to the next line. So it will enter one character at the end of the row or line wherever you will press enter, and it will move to the next line. Another function of this is to start a process. Maybe there is some button in an application or to start a process. So this key is normally used for that purpose, right? And then you have these arrow keys. Left means to move left side, right to move right, up and down, straightforward, very simple. Then we have this control key. It also having the same function. Few places you need this control. Alone this control or shift key will not do anything, or even function key. So these key are useless if you press them alone. There will be no functionality. But you have to press these with a combination, right? Shift 4 means dollar sign. Okay, so function key with the, let's say for example, I think if I'm not, okay, here F12, that means increase the volume as per this keyboard, right? You can see your own keyboard, what are the signs over there. It might be slight different keyboard to keyboard, right? But overall standards will be the same, right? Somewhere there is a window button here. Once you will click that, it will open this start menu, right? This is how the keyboard is, and this is your space bar to jump to the right one character or one space, right? Okay. What I'm going to do, I think once you will practice, share your feedback if you are following, but please make sure it needs some patience initially. It is not easy, because if you are already typing with some pattern, it might be a bit difficult. But if you will focus that just you have to learn this way, then practice will make you perfect. Okay, now in next video I'm planning, I will share with you a bit background or inside working of the keyboard. Let's say for example, once you click a button A, how computer or keyboard knows that it has to the user has typed A and it has to print A. What are the basis of this, right? So once you will press J, it will not print A, right? So there is some mechanism behind the scene. I will share you those calculation standards in another video, because this is not the scope of this video, because it will confuse you further, right? Share your feedback if you find this video useful. Share with your beginners who want to learn professional usage of keyboard, I will say, and let them be perfect, right? Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz for today.